I know normally when someone says side hustle, or when you see a side hustle video, and when you click on it, all you get to hear is micro influencing or being an influencer or starting a YouTube channel or driving Uber or being a makeup artist or being a hairstylist. Sis, there are more side hustles that we can do. Welcome back again to another video. If you're new here, hello, welcome. My name is Matilda, and in this channel we talk about business development, entrepreneur, we share free vendors, everything as a whole, how you can be your own boss or how you can navigate life like a boss. So in today's video, I've put together some side hustles for you guys, specifically for my ladies. Side hustle that you can do and generate a good sum of money at the same time you can actually walk your way to a career path with these side hustles that I'm gonna mention today. But before I go into today's video, I want to say Merry Christmas and a happy, prosperous, healthy 2022. I hope you all had a very good Christmas, and I hope you all have set some good goals for 2022. So with no further talking, I'm gonna go straight into the side hustles I have put together for you guys. I know normally when someone says side hustle, or when you see a side hustle video, and when you click on it, all you get to hear is micro influencing or being an influencer or starting a YouTube channel or driving Uber or being a makeup artist or being a hairstylist. Sis, there are more side hustles that we can do as a woman. A lot of the time they get to make us feel like, oh, these type of things women cannot do it. Anything a man can do, a woman can do it 10 times. When I say 10 times, I mean it 10 times. So with all that being said, let's go into today's video or the side hustles I have put together for you guys. I'm gonna be looking down on my phone because I have my notes on my phone. So please bear with me if you see me keep going down and up. So first side hustle that you want to do is customer interviews. So what is a customer interview? So a customer interview is pretty much like when a particular company interview a customer, but in this case you might have the product, or you might have purchased this product, and you're giving like a review or feedback when it comes to the particular product that you own. Let's say Apple released a new phone, or Apple released a new AirPod, or Apple released a new MacBook, and then you purchase this item. And sometimes when a manufacturer creates a particular product in the manufacturer factory, it works perfectly. But the moment you take it out of that factory, it doesn't work the way it was working at the manufacturing outlet or factory. It just malfunctioned. So in that case, they always try to look for feedback or people's thoughts, or what people that have purchased the product, what do they think. So they pay people to do an interview. I will actually put two websites. These are websites that you can go and you can do these interviews. So one of them is called User Interviews and also Respondent.io. I'll put it on the screen and you can check them out. The minimum you will get for this interview is $50 an hour, upwards to $300 an hour. This is a very good side hustle if you decide to do this. For example, let's say on Sundays you don't work. If you are someone that works 9-to-5 job, let's say you don't work on Saturdays and Sundays, and you said, okay, I'll just take 5 hours of my time today and just do this survey. $50, that's a minimum. That's the minimum you will get. But let's say $50 times 5, you already make $250 in 5 hours. That's a lot of money. Hopefully my math is correct. $250 a day. If you decide to spend 10 hours, that's $500. So the more time you put into it, the more money you make. I'm just using the minimum amount just to do a calculation, but sometimes you get $150, $200. It depends on the company. Now you find all this Samsung, all this LG, big brands on this website I just gave to you, looking for customer reviews. And when you go there, if you have any particular product that you already own, you can just make a review about it and tell them what are your thoughts and get your coin. Another side hustle that you can also do as a female is corporate event planning. Corporate event planning is quite similar to event planning, but when it comes to corporate event planning, the money is a little bit high. Just by the name, you can tell that this is very, very professional job. A corporate event planning. So if you live in a particular district or particular state, try to look out or reach out to local businesses, because sometimes they don't have time to put all that work into planning events. Sometimes they will have like a workshop. Let's say they're trying to develop their brand or their small business. So they want to cooperate. There's always, even without independent corporate event planner, there is always a particular section in every company that just does the event planning. So if you are working with small businesses, at that particular point they can't afford to pay that particular section or add that to their business yet, you will make a good sum of money whereby they will call you occasionally. So by the time you start to develop a relationship with different type of organization or small businesses, and then every weekend, let's say, or every weekdays, one day in a week, you have a particular event to plan, that is a really good sum of money. So let's say you have a part-time job, or you are a stay-at-home mom, you can actually do that, because it's not a daily basis, it's not a 9-to-5. But every one or two event planning you do for a week, that will actually make you or generate you like a week income for someone that work on a daily basis, like 9-to-5 job. You might make that in a day or in a couple of days. So it is a really, really good side also for my females or my women empowerment. Okay, anyway, another side hustle that you can do is catering. You don't need any specialty, or you don't need to go to school for that. If you are someone that is very passionate about cooking and you are good in cooking on budget, this is a perfect side hustle for you. You can try to liaise with someone, or try to work with someone that does event planning or corporate event planning. So when they have an event, you guys can work together as partner and you can do the food section. It's also a very, very good business to do. Another side hustle, oh my god, my camera is about to go off. Another side hustle that you can do is medical transcriptionist. So it sounds very professional, it sounds like you need a degree. No, so you know, let's say people that works in IT, or people that works in which other field should I use, in the medical, you know, they have some type of terminology that they use. So let's say you already work in the medical field and you understand the terminology, you can be a medical transcriptionist. It's a very rare thing for you to hear someone say, oh, I'm a medical transcriptionist. Oh my god, why am I struggling to pronounce this word? It's very rare for you to hear someone say, I'm a medical transcriptionist. It's a very rare job, but it's a very, very good job that will make you a huge sum of money. And also, if you're someone that's into helping people, you love rendering service, or you know, you're a people's person, it's a perfect side also, especially for my people in the medical field. If you're already working as a nurse, or you're a doctor, or you are a pharmacy doctor, this is a very, very good side hustle that you can do, and it's quite a lot of money in that area. And as I mentioned, it's very rare for you to see people doing that. Another side hustle that you can also do is small business marketing, or becoming a small business marketer. So for all the small businesses, they can't afford to order a marketer, or let's say a professional marketer, because they are quite expensive. And small businesses are always looking for a way, you know, to reach out to more audience and to get their brand out there. If you're someone that's good in selling something, or you have worked in that field before, you have an experience, it's a very good side hustle that you can do. And you make, because as I said, you make a lot of money every day. They are opening businesses, so you will get a really good sum of money, because small businesses are going to actually work with you, because the fact that you have categorized yourself as a small business marketer, people will look for you, and it is a really, really good side hustle, and you will generate, as I said, a really good sum of money. Another one is preparing taxes. In Australia, I know if you work or you have filed a tax before, you know, preparing taxes, like if you do as a side hustle, I will say it's seasonal, because they don't do it like all the time or every year. people that own businesses, they sometimes file in on a week, on a monthly basis, but 80% of the time people file once in a year. So if you're doing that as a side also, you understand you are you work in the finance sector or you have worked in that sector before, you have an idea, you can do that as a side hustle. But as I said, it's seasonal, so it's once in a year. So it's something, if it's something that you like doing or you enjoy doing, you can also look into that. Another side also that you can do is computer repair service. Let's say you work in a technology section. I'm seeing a lot of female these days working in IT, and I'm super proud. I'm so happy, because before, for you to see a female IT is after 10 male and then you see one female. We're now like, oh, we are winning, guys. So if you're working in that sector, everybody owns computer these days. Every single person, like if not 100%, but 99% people own a laptop, so there's more laptop to repair. So it's also a very good side also, and it's always in high demand. So if you work in an IT sector, that is something is really good. And even if you don't work in an IT sector, let's say you are someone that loves computer ever since you were a kid, you have an idea on what you're doing, it is also a really good side also. Another side hustle is a virtual recruiter. I know a lot of the time we hear virtual assistant, but a virtual recruiter is a big sector when it comes to any organization or any company, because the company needs to employ people every now and then, and they need a recruiter. So if it's a small business, or let's say it's not a huge business yet, they are still trying to grow up, they might not have that, you know, that facility in their company to employ people. If you're good at understanding people, interview people, asking questions, be able to figure out the right candidate for the right job, it is a perfect side hustle for you. Another side hustle that you can do is survey taking. But with survey taking, it's a very little sum of money. So if you're looking for a side hustle that can generate you a huge amount of money, I don't think survey taking is for you, because there's like $10 for one survey. So you might need to put a lot of time to generate a huge sum of money. So you might put in like 20, 30, 40 hours in a week just to get like a couple of $100 or $300. So if you want to generate huge sum of money, then survey taking is not a good idea. But if you don't mind, it's little actually adds up. So $5-$10 adds up. By the time you know it, it's $500, then you can take in that as a side hustle. Another side hustle that you can do is create after school program. So this is perfect for my single moms, or let's say stay at home moms. This is a perfect also that you can do. Create like a little space in your house and do some after school care. There are always parents looking for where to drop their kids after school, or where they get their kids can go after school. And if you live in a small district, perfect for you to reach out to friends from church, from your friends, colleague, whosoever is looking to drop their kids somewhere. You can tell people like, hey, I do after school care at home, or you can create a little wall bill and just post it somewhere, and people can easily find you. Or you can go to schools and tell them you have an after school care. I know some schools do have after school care, so it's gonna be like very competitive if you go to them and tell them you're having an after school care. And probably if your price is a little bit, you know, lower, it's gonna be something. But make sure you do a research, know the school you're going to. If they don't have after school care, you can offer that service. But especially your local community, it can be a very good side hustle that you can do for my stay at home mom or single moms, or someone, even someone struggling to get a job. Another side hustle that you can do is organizing service. I was watching Dara Taylor's video this morning, and she actually booked an organizer. So if you're someone that have just a special skill, or you just enjoy packing everything in order, you love organizing, this can be a very good side hustle. You can post on Facebook Market, says organizer, I don't know what. You can just put on Facebook, advertise yourself, create an Instagram page, try to reach out to your friend, give some complimentary, give some cards out, how people can reach you, and also do that. It's a very good business and a very good side hustle at the same time. You can actually turn it into a business. As I told you guys earlier, the side hustles I'm giving today, it's something that can also be like a career for you. So I hope this was helpful. I'm gonna bring a part two of side hustles for female my next video, hopefully it's gonna be my next video or the video after. So if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe. Please don't forget to share. You don't know, maybe someone is currently looking or struggling to get a side hustle to do, and I've mentioned something here that they are passionate about. If you share it, it might help them. Sharing is caring, as I always say. So I'm gonna wrap this video here. Stay blessed, stay safe, enjoy your 2022, and I'll see you all on my next video. Peace.